Okay, well, we won't do. Actually. Alright, whatever. This will be fine.
Let the games begin.
I'm gonna be dropping Arcane Blast. I think it's mostly for Manitide Totem with an Arcane Blast ping, but since I have the Doomsayer already. I feel like we're just gonna have to do this. If he plays Totem Golem, then he'll have 5 power board for Flame Tongue or any spell at that point. I'm having this weird problem right now with my stream not starting up even though it's 5 minute delay. This is kind of like a Twitch problem that I've been having a lot. Just in general. We have the Cabal's Tomes, our hand's really heavy. I'm not gonna wait till Bran Kazak is in 7. Well, plus he doesn't have 4 on board, and I don't think it's mostly surviving, but at least he can't Jade Lightning here. I'm not gonna wait till like, I'm not, even with Ink Master, since I need a 5 drop right now, I don't count Cabal's Tome as a good 5 drop. I'm not gonna take the 10 mana potion with Ink Master. I'm gonna take a 5 second play, a 5 mana potion next turn, potentially.
Job done.
Ooh, nice, got a Firelands Portal. I doubt it bloodlust if I played Sylvanas here, but also I'm not getting too much more value. Perhaps. It's a good tempo play, and my hand is pretty heavy. Plus, I'm leading into the Firelands Portal turn here with Ink Master. If my hand was like less good for tempo right now, maybe I could just Sylvanas, take a risk, take like 10-ish damage, and if he hexes my Sylvanas. Then I would just AoE the next turn, but it's like he might have a Manitide here. He'll probably have to roll first, yeah. In some ways, like, that's the best Flame Strike turn because his Jade camps at 5 now, but this is still. It's still not worth it over Firelands Portal here. Oh, apparently we're alive now. It just takes, like, I don't know. Twitch has been tilting me. He only has one more Hex. Let's do this, actually. Oh, that might be worth it. I was gonna fireball here.
Warriors come out to play.
Looks like a pretty good flame strike. Got a Medivh now. I have the Medivh, no Antonitis anymore, but I have Medivh and the Cabal's Tome. I figure Cabal's Tome has more synergy with Medivh. We're just gonna be looking to push for tempo. How much damage do we have? Fireball Torch is 9, 10, 15, so we're 3 off lethal here. So Since we don't have AoE, I think we need to keep the tempo up. Like, the problem with Medivh is if he has Hex, he trades in Hex's Medivh, and if I had like a Flame Strike or other kind of like better AoE, I could, because I get a lot of tempo back with the Great Theft, but the problem is I don't have AoE, so it's still kind of iffy. Maybe Sylvanas can bait out Hex. I mean, technically, they just trade on board with Sylvanas, but that's, I think it's fine for me. It's just so expensive for him to trade on board. Actually, I actually could have traded for the injured Kvaldir and make it harder for them. For him to do that. That might have been better. 5 face damage I thought was worth a lot though. I figure he's in bad shape if he has to double trade for Sylvanas anyways. Although now I just made a totem, so I don't think he's even planning on trading with Sylvanas. Or if he make that trade anyways, works out for me. Making some weird plays because his totem's getting stolen now. I'm gonna try to pull his last Jade card here, if he has one. Okay, I like that. That's less healing. Hey, how are you guys doing? We missed yesterday. See if we can get the 12 wins playing like all bad matchups. I have managed a lot of bad matchups right now, Priest. They're like theoretically bad matchups, but I'm hoping that it's not as bad because of how I tune my deck, I guess. Against Dragon Priest, so like Sylvanas, Medivh, those are key cards. I was very close to taking out Manic Soulcaster for MC Tech. I'm not sure if it's right. Once upon a time. That's huge, I hit the drop. Because if I can play Blood Mage and then he plays the 3-4, and then I have the spell power of Blood Mage. I'm still playing Blood Mage here, I believe. Just to get some cycle going. Exposes myself to Norishar Cleric, but the reason why I like playing Blood Mage is because of Potion of Madness later in the game. So I don't want to ever play Blood Mage with another minion on my side of the field because he can potion the Blood Mage and steal my card draw. So because of all that, I still think it's better to just play it out here. I have an answer for Norishar Cleric if he has it. That's good news for me. Misses 3 drop. And this is not really a great Pirate Shield target. We don't get the curve out if he has Shattered Pain, but he has hard time having 2 drops with how he plays. Like, he probably doesn't have more 1 and 2 drops. Probably has 4 drops. So, like, we're both losing some mana if he has Shattered Pain. And he might just go play Twilight Guardian, in which case I can Fireball it using my mana perfectly. I'm actually gonna ping here. It exposed myself to Cleric in this turn in some ways, but because of the Azure Drake next turn, and he sometimes trades the one, like say he plays Azure Drake this turn, or just, you know, whatever. Like sometimes he actually trades in the 1-4, and then Black and Corruptors, and then I wanna have damage. Turn 5 is a really bad turn for him to Northshire Cleric. Let's take out these, like, high damage, high health minions. I guess we're trying to win with a combination of value and tempo in the mid game. We have multiple options, but I want to make sure he doesn't take good value trades. We probably combo Drake with Frostbolt at some point.
My work is paramount. Leave me alone.
My shield for Argus.
Perfect draw here.
I have no time for games.
You wish to live forever.
Oh, that's a lot of guys. Wow, he does not care about AoE at all. Gets punished for it. Okay, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 18. We should probably Blizzard. Let's take out the dragon. Okay, yeah. I guess we want to get our Swanus killed. We have Volcanic Kazakus. If we AI and fail, Frostbolt ping 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I feel like Toma's better. Gives us a better option if we fail. Go with the Frostbolt ping, it's better use of mana. Because we pick up the AoE, I feel like this is better. I have so many polymorphs. I could just die here to fireball, but don't really have a choice. Need to draw our ice block arena soon.
Is someone injured?
I really need Reno. Thing is, if I go Drake, ping, and like a whatever, you know, Corruptor kills me, it's very likely he has Black and Corruptor. So I need to kill two minions here. I think I need a draw. He's used one pain. I'm probably dead. I would die to this Black and Corruptor if I didn't pull it too, and because this is a taunt at least. I'm hoping he doesn't have a Shek Second Pain. Yeah. Even if it didn't play, this would have killed me with the 3 damage and the Black and Corruptor Battle Cry.
Games begin.
We want as much removal as possible against Rogue and card draw. This is kind of a perfect hand. I actually like keeping Ice Block, maybe even more so than Reno in this matchup, because Reno without Ice Block against Rogue is only like 15 points of healing, kind of, because you have to play around first a lot for Rogue. So I actually like keeping Ice Block. This is a new development for me. I used to not do this. But, I think it's good, like, as I get better at the game and learn new things.
I don't have to be a princess.
Technically, it's better use of mana for us, the coin AI here. Because we need to develop our block at some point as well. Yeah, our curve is really heavy. The only problem with this is kind of Tomb Pillager in 4 in some ways. Because then I don't have the torch coin ping for 4 damage. A true polymorph, it's good. There's 2 mage cards. I'm gonna be torching this. Polymorph's good. It's really good against 2 pillager, and it's really good against Vancleave. That's really good. Shlaba, thanks for the sub. Welcome to the Strife crew. Here is a Crowfist. We are a little bit behind in the delay, but we'll get to it eventually. Shaku, Sousi, I'm trying to categorize this rogue as a Miracle or Aggro right now. Still.
This guy's toast.
A little bit unsure. Oh, nice. I was gonna have to make a weird move here because I had 5 mana and I need to ping a 6-1, so I either had to ping Dirty Rat to use my mana, kinda weird, or Kazakus and 1 mana potion and pray, which is also weird, so that was so good. Whoa, Vancleave. Oh, wow. That's a. Okay. I like Emperor. We're getting close to dying. Hopefully, no one loses our block, but we can Kazakus and get some armor. I still don't like Kazakus this turn, Dirty Rat this turn. Because if I play Emperor, I can play Flame Strike with Dirty Rat. That's not good for me. I mean, it's kind of okay. I'd probably have 2 polymorphs. I think we take 1 mana. We have 1 mana to spare this turn. That might have been the perfect one. We're still trying to draw for Reno. Also, Murdocracy, thanks for the resub for 4 months. Welcome back to the Strife crew. Here is a Crowfist. I don't like playing Dirty Rat last turn. We have Dirty Rat Flamestrike together. Hopefully pull the Leroy or Gadgetzan here. We're going for it this turn. This is our good Flamestrike turn anyways. Yeah. I mean, I could portal ping, but the problem is I don't develop the taunt, and I don't get the, like, if he's holding Gadgetzan and trying to, you know, miracle out in a later turn, this is huge. Or Leroy. Leroy, there we go. If he has big stealth guys, no. Right now, like, he has 4 cards in his hand. It's hard for him to make big Vancleaves with 4 cards in his hand with stealth. Right, Blizzard is better against, like, big stealth Vancleaves in questings. But Flamestrike is better against Concealed Auctioneer. So I like saving the Flamestrike, because the Conceal, like, with 5 cards in his hand, it's hard for him to miracle out too strong to create these, like, crazy Vancleave stealth guys. So I like the Flamestrike more. Looks like he's not a Miracle Rogue at all. There's no Gadgetzan. I wasn't sure until now, but now I'm pretty sure. I did lose the dog earlier. Turning close, because he's killing me so slow, but at least if he has, like, a Eviscerate here, he pops me at 4 or 3, and then he needs, you know, he can just dagger me down. Get 2 draws here. I mean, I'm pretty sure he's dead. I have two burn spells for next turn, so even if he gets my block, he'll die regardless of whether I draw Reno or not. Almost certainly, at least. It's a mistake, right? This is a good matchup for Reno Mage. See, this is a reason to play Mage. I thought that there would be a decent amount of rogues after the meta's kind of evolving after the patch. Go ahead and keep Pauly because he has a coin. With the coin, it's easier for him to play Big Van Cleaves. Coin to build during 3, and then I can polymorph in a 4.
I'm in charge now.
We should always kill Swashbroker here. People have been running Shadow Step, like last game they were running Shadow Step. Not that it's a huge thing, but sometimes when they have nothing to do, they Shadow Step the Swashbroker to get another card. Especially if they're going like Shadow Step, Coin, Swashbuckler, Vinkleaf. Good thing I have a play here with Backlight. If I didn't have a play Shock, it's weird because of the stealth. Like, I can't torch it and kind of waste a lot of mana this turn if I don't have Backlight. He didn't attack after that Shock you. It's, in a way, it's a little bit surprising. I don't think they run a lot of 3-2s. The thing is, Torch can kill Azure Drake, but I have 2 spell power minions left over. Let's do this. Brief Candles, thanks for the resub. Welcome to the Strife crew. Here is a Crow Fist. We have good AoE, we could use this turn to tome, but we also have a good Ooze turn, Ooze, Arcane Blast, Ping. There's already 4 damage, yeah, I like this better. Removes like 6 power on board permanently. Oh no, that's a huge reason not to play Ooze, because now he has his target. Like, this is usually not that good sometimes against Mage. I'm just delaying the inevitable if I Blizzard here, unless I get really lucky and top deck Flamestriker Potion the turn after. I'm hoping he doesn't run Sap. Because most aggro rogues do not run sap, from what I've seen. Old face, probably. So with Frostbolt, I can Frostbolt trade Ping. Blizzard, I should save a Dirty Rat. So the question, I leave up one Bluegill Warrior if I go Cabal's Tome. and then Frostbolt trade. 1, 2, 3. I could die to Leroy Coldblood. I probably shouldn't get too greedy with a Dirty Rat Blizzard together, because I can't do that anyways if I'm gonna need a Reno. I'm just gonna Blizzard here. It's a breakpoint because Leroy Coldblood doesn't kill me right now. I should be in good shape this game, I think. If I can just get the Reno off. I believe I'm gonna just ping in Reno and not Frostbolt the Drake. Still save the Frostbolt. I could definitely still lose though, because I only got 19 healing from Reno, and I don't have too much more healing in my deck. I need tempo plays now. Abyssal of Force is better than Antonidas here, I need AoE. Oh, it's not too bad. Shadow Step. Might be hesitant using it if he has Leroy in his hand. It's a good read for Dirty Rat. But I'm gonna need a ping with the Abyssal Enforcer on the 5-4, so I can't Dirty Rat Abyssal Enforcer. That makes more sense for him, I think. Yeah. It's worse against what I have, but... He's used two Eviscerates already. I think I kill a 5-4. He is frozen, so even if I let the 5-4, I can't trade the 5-1 and then the dagger in because he's frozen, but still, I don't see a reason to do it anyways because he's only has one backstab left. Like, he's two Eviscerates and one backstab, so I just think this is straight up better. Might be holding Leroy. We want to Dirty Rat it if we can. No. We're gonna just rat next turn. It's better use of resources, I feel. Mana, not just mana, but better use of like removal to taunt ratio, right? Because I'd rather not let him trade into the Dirty Rat with a 4-1 and then be. I'd rather have the Dirty Rat later than to, in this spot than to have the whatever, you know, the torch at this point. We want to play this before Frylance Portal. So Naga Sea Witch doesn't screw us over. I was right all along. Nerlin HS, thanks for the sub. Welcome to the Strife Crew. Well, here's Crowfist.
Let the game begin.
This kills a Manatee totem. Interesting. He's playing Murloc. Well, good thing I have the Starcane Blast. That's good Murloc to kill. It grows a lot. So he's playing one of those. What's the card? Like a everything can happen. Call to Murloc. Call to Arms. I don't know. 5 mana 7/4 1/1 Murlocs, I believe. Well, I got a great hand against this deck. I have Reno and Kazakus against the, I guess, minion swarming Murloc deck. If we just get AoE from Kazakus, the Murloc strategy's not gonna work out well for him. Since we have 2/4 drops, I'm probably gonna not coin out Acolyte of Pain. Although, that's a really good. No way. Because he can play War Leader, right? And then just absolutely screw me over if I play Acolyte. Because not only does he value trade against the Acolyte of Pain, I burn my coin, which I need for Water Elemental. If he plays War Leader, I might just Frostbolt it, but we'll see. Okay. It's actually very good for me because he's overloaded and he has a very. His low damage board is only 5 damage and it trades very poorly with Water Elemental, like very, very poorly. Even with Flame Tongue, it doesn't trade that well, actually, right? Like 3 plus 4, he has to trade 2 of these in. I get to do too much here. Although, I'm actually really tempted to Kazakus the more I think about it. I'm removing 4 power with Frostbolt ping, but Kazakus is developing a 3-3. He has 1 Murloc, so I don't think I need to kill the 1 Murloc immediately for War Leader.
Interesting.
If I Frostbolt ping, I'm stuck playing Kazakus in 1 mana potion next turn. I cannot rely on my board sticking around with a 4 health here. Draw's not that good if I have Reno already, but I need to pick up AoE still. If I already had Flamestrike or Blizzard, I would have taken 7 armor, I believe. Kind of awkward for me to curve out. I need a Frostbolt Acolyte, but pinging is almost worth more than playing Acolyte. Perhaps. Yeah, this just trades better on board. Oracle, in a way, is scarier if you, like, if you play some stuff where I don't get to ping the Oracle, but I have 2 minions to contest it, so. That's a good one. I'm gonna trade now because he might AoE. It's very likely he kills both minions, but just in case, I don't have like any more AoE in my hand to deal with the Flame Breathed, and I definitely don't want to Fireball or Kazakus Potion it. Like I might play Reno next turn as well, which in which case, you know, I don't get. I would have to trade anyways with the Flame Breathed. Oh, that would have buffed the Flame Breathed as well. That's quite powerful. It's 12 damage on board. If only we got an AoE. Oh well. What if we Fireball plus, like, Bran? I died to second call on the finishers. This one top deck that kills me. And Leroy. 1 in 20. I have to play to win. If I play Rina, I take 12 and go to 18, and I have no AoE, and the Rina trades is 1, then I take 9 again. It's like 18 plus 9 is 27. Like, I would die for 2 turns or 3 turns, depending on how these, like, depending on what I draw. Here I see, I don't see a better play now. Nothing even remotely reasonable. I mean, he's top decking Finja here. He doesn't, like, if this card isn't like Lightning Bolt or anything that could change the health of this, like, it's real. He can't even Finja here, right? Like, there's no breakpoint that allows him to even get the last hit. But yeah, we'll see what his card is. Oh, okay. It's a big card, but his Finja is unactivated. I wonder if he's gonna unstealth Finja. I would say so, yeah. You are not the boss of me. Ooh, volcanic. Which actually doesn't seem really good right now. I don't want to give him a Finja target, because he has War Leader still. It's too risky. I could have pinged Finja, or pinged the other guy instead for Volcanic better, but I feel like it's too risky if he gets cards that bust Murlocs. Oh, nice. Ooh. Blood Mage, Volcanic, ping. And I have 3 mana left over. Okay. Let's do this first. Nephike, thanks for the sub. Welcome to the Strife crew. Welcome back. Here is a Crowfist.
Again, so kind of you to join me.
This matchup is way too slow. I mean, way too fast for me to save the weapon and, you know, ping instead of playing a ooze. Oh, I'm warp stuff on board. Mostly gonna be weak to like patches stuff. Fiery Bat can still have the death rattle here. Most of the Murlocs are just for Finja. They don't really keep any. I would say even if we don't get Battlecry value, it's better to play the Fiery Bat turn 1 compared to playing it on turn 3. Yay, I was on a Crowfist.
Uh-huh.
He could kill my war leader if I don't trade. Like, I'm not that weak to Maelstrom. So, I guess with this play, if we play Trog, Hero Power, get two more damage in because we get squeezed into Hero Power. Playing this relies on us top decking something we can play. This worked out for us with the curve. It's better to try to hit this guy, I think, than to try to hit Princess. Especially since if my 2-2 survives here, then I can use Princess to activate the 3-2. Now, something to think about is... I'm probably playing Finja regardless, though. We could take a value trade, but we're Hunter, actually. Hunter makes more sense to go to face here. Although 6-5 is significantly stronger, and I don't know how I'm going to be able to activate my Death Rattle after this. So I'm actually strongly considering Princess here. If I'm playing Princess, I'm still going face. I'm not trading for the 1-1 here. It's not good against Flame Tongue, but a lot of people aren't playing Flame Tongue right now in Jade. Like, we don't care if he trades 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 in, right? Like, we're not trying to protect our Princess. Because he can't afford to use Jade Claws anyways. Okay, so the issue here is Finja can't one-shot any of these guys, so I might want to hit this so I can kill something with Finja. Now the problem with hitting it is he can have taunts like thing from below and I have the quick shot to make up for that, and then it's like kind of pointless to attack it. I think so, because like Aya is a turn 6 play and he can trade Jade Claws into my 2-2 and then trade a 3-3 Jade Golem into the Big Bad Wolf. Like, if I went face, he's not going to take the Jade Golem trade here and then the Jade Claws trade into the 3-2. Because, you know, then I have the food for Finja right now. Like, for Hunter, it's not exactly easy to set the breakpoints a lot of times. I guess that's one weakness of Hunter with Finja. Okay, yeah, Aya, perfect. I'm glad I traded into the Manatide. Now, with this, what happened, he might just go face. It would make sense for him to trade if he... Like, if I didn't attack the Manatide, but now that I attacked the Manatide, it's kind of likely he just whatevers at this point. Do I have lethal next turn? So you get 4 damage with the charger, and then we have... 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, it's guaranteed lethal. And Zeria, thanks for the sub. Welcome to the Strife crew. Here's a crow fist. Glad it went so well for us, like all that face damage paid off early. It's hard to fight for board control with Hunter, like against weapons. It's a good curve. Rat Packs can take care of early pirates. And he's going first, so it's like he goes first, I play Fireback, he just Hero Power turn 2.